Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
We already derived a motional EMF equation using Newton's second law. However, there's actually a completely different way to derive this same motional EMF equation.
You know we love redundancy.
We love redundancy.
We do?
Sure.
Yeah.
This approach starts with a conductor moving to the right while in contact with two parallel metal rails connected by a wire at the left end with a uniform magnetic field going into the screen. The resistance of the circuit is represented by the resistor shown in the wire on the left. A force is applied to the conductor to cause it to move to the right. Notice, a conducting loop is created by the wire on the left, the two parallel conducting rails, and the conductor which is being pushed to the right. And the area of the loop is increasing in size, which means the magnetic flux through the loop is changing, which means there is an induced EMF and an induced current in the loop. We can use Lenz's law to determine the direction of the induced current in the loop. Bo, please determine the direction of the induced current in the loop.
Sure. The magnetic field is into the screen because the conductor is moving to the right. The area of the conducting loop is increasing in size. That means the number of magnetic field lines passing through the conducting loop is increasing, which means the magnetic flux is increasing. According to Lenz's law, the induced magnetic field opposes the change in flux. Therefore, the induced magnetic field inside the conducting loop is out of the screen. Using the alternate right-hand rule, our fingers curl in the direction of the induced magnetic field, which is, again, out of the screen, inside the conducting loop. Our thumb points in the counterclockwise direction from this perspective, which is the direction of the induced current in the loop. Yeah, there is an induced current in the loop, which is up through the moving conductor.
Thanks, Bo. Notice this means that because positive charges are moving in the direction of conventional current in the conductor, we can use the right-hand rule to show that the fingers point in the direction of the motion of the positive charges, which is up. Fingers curl in the direction of the magnetic field, which is into the screen. And our thumb points in the direction of the magnetic force on the moving positive charges, which is to the left. In other words, there is a magnetic force which opposes the motion of the conductor in the magnetic field. Realize you get the same result for negative charges moving opposite the direction of conventional current in the conductor. Now, Bobby, please use Faraday's law to determine the magnitude of the induced EMF in the moving conductor.
Okay, Faraday's law states that the induced EMF in multiple conductive loops equals the negative of the number of loops times the derivative of the magnetic flux through a single loop with respect to time. Magnetic flux equals the magnetic field times the area of the loops times the cosine of the angle between the magnetic field and the area of the loops. The number of loops in this case is 1. The magnetic field does not change over time, so that can be taken out of the derivative. The angle is also constant over time and can be taken out of the derivative. Actually, let's figure out the angle. The magnetic field is into the screen for the direction of the area of the loop. Well, the conventional current is counterclockwise from this perspective, so curl the fingers of our right hand counterclockwise, and our thumb points out of the screen, so the direction of the area is out of the screen. Okay, so because the magnetic field is into the screen and the loop area vector is out of the screen, the angle is 180 degrees. But what do I do with the area variable? I do not know what the derivative of area with respect to time is.
Let's identify the variable distance the moving conductor is from the wire on the left as a variable distance x. In other words, as the conductor moves to the right, the value of x increases.
Sure, that makes sense. The area of the loop then is capital L times x, and L is constant over time, which means we can take L out from the derivative, and the derivative of x position with respect to time is velocity. We just derived the same equation for motional EMF as we did before. Motional EMF equals velocity times magnetic field times the length of the conductor.
And again, this equation assumes the angle between the velocity of the conductor and the magnetic field is 90 degrees. If it is not, you can leave the cosine of the angle in the equation.
But the way we did it before had the sine of theta in it. This way has the cosine of the angle instead.
This way of deriving the motional EMF equation defines theta as the angle between the loop area vector and the magnetic field. The way we did it before defined theta as the angle between the direction of the velocity of the conductor and the magnetic field. The loop area vector and the velocity of the moving conductor are at a right angle to one another, which is why one of these equations uses cosine and the other uses sine.
Okay. Thank you, everybody. Well done. And thank you for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.